All right, moving on to our next speaker this evening, ladies and gentlemen, who's here to talk to us about the role of digital marketing in real estate. He is Director, Sai Estate Consultants. Please put your hands together for Mr. Amit Wadhwani.
Hi, very good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Amit Wadhwani and I run this company called Sai Estate Consultants. And it's an interesting subject to talk about digital advertising, because I was looking at the research reports here and I feel I didn't see any of the real estate players to be serious and dominant players as far as digital spends are concerned. You will see a lot of our company ads on the OOH in the print medium, but digital is one platform where I feel the real estate players haven't really understood what digital can do for real estate as far as sales and marketing is concerned. So we spend close to about 4 lakh rupees per day on all digital platforms, including SEO, SEM, and which is still considered a smaller piece of the pie of what we do on a daily basis in the outdoor, which is about 6.5-7 lakh rupees per day, and in the print, which is close to about 12.5-13 lakh rupees per day. I think the whole problem here is about what the Indian developers have done in the last 20 to 25 years. They have really taken the Indian consumers for a ride, because of which credibility in the digital space becomes a big question mark. Most of the projects here that we market, our Indian developers, whether in the island city of Mumbai or in NCR, are all looking at creating an impression by buying jackets in the front couple of 2 pages of leading newspapers, because they feel that is where the credibility will come in from. If you look at the outdoor consumption in Mumbai, 75% to 80% of outdoor is consumed by the real estate players, and then the rest of it is consumed by the telecom players. I think on the digital platform, what currently needs to be done is the realtors have to understand that digital leads will give them more impetus when it comes to convincing a client. If you buy, example, a Mumbai Mirror page 1 or page 2, which will cost you about 10.5-11 lakh rupees, that is good for the day, could get you about 300 phone calls, with an average cost at our end still is between 20 to 22,000 rupees per lead, versus a digital lead which comes at about 200-300 rupees per lead. That's a cost per lead. Still, a lot of Indian developers feel that print is a dominant medium when it comes to conversions, when it comes to getting business out of Indian consumers. At our end, we sell close to about 175 flats every weekend. That takes us to a number of about 6,000 crore rupees of sales that we do at our company's end, at Sai Estate Consultants, out of our offices in Mumbai and in Delhi. A lot of it still comes from various platforms on the print and outdoor medium. Digital, as per our understanding, takes close to about 6 to 8 weeks for a client to decide upon, versus a print lead till date gives us instant gratification in terms of a client will look at a newspaper in the morning, will come in the afternoon, will try and close a deal in the evening. That is the understanding that the realtors or the developers have at this point in time. I think it's only time where people understand that digital is a medium which gives more information, instant information. A lot of our our developers also feel that displaying their projects in the digital space exposes them to instant comments and feedback from dissatisfied consumers, which is also a big issue currently the way the entire real estate sector has performed in the last 15 to 20 years. So I feel brands wherein there is more transparency, like the Godrej, the Shapojis of the world, will have more traction, will use digital medium effectively. And real estate brands in the NCR section or Mumbai section or Bangalore, where they have not really performed very well, would not want to come on the digital platform because they would feel that this would expose them to comments or would expose them the certain aspects of the project which they really don't want to highlight. So I feel the real estate sector, why it is not really made, why is it not featured in one of the highest spenders in the digital space, is because Indian real estate unfortunately still runs about 15 to 20 years behind what a London or New York or an Australian real estate company would run at. But we are all optimistic and progressive that in years to come, real estate will also be a player that is one of the highest spenders apart from retail and other industries. And the value of a real estate lead will be better understood by realtors now that the real estate regulator is also in place, which is more or less a digital platform which gives you all the information on the Maharashtra RERA website. About the developer is not a hard copy, it's not a print copy, it is basically e-information that is passed on to the consumers. So it is only time that the real estate segment, and more so because I belong to the real estate broking segment, will continue and will go strength to strength in contributing to the $5 billion target that, so to say, we have set for the digital industry in India. Thank you very much for this opportunity, and I hope to be a part of more such events in times to come. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much, Mr. Wadhwani. I request you to please stay with me on stage. And I'd like to invite Mr. Uday Sodhi, EVP and Head Digital Business, Sony Pictures Networks India. Mr. Uday, are you in the room? Okay, there he is. So if you could please present a token of our gratitude to Mr. Wadhwani. Fantastic. Thank you very much.